Welcome, friends. This program is sponsored by Dance Awareness, No Child Exploited, better known as DANCE. I'm founder and dance educator Mary Bodden. Check out our website at danceawareness.com to understand the differences between healthy and harmful dance. And now it's my pleasure to introduce to you our teacher for What's the Point, Terrill Corletto.
Hi guys, my name is Terrill Corletto and this is Sarah Stromberger.
Hello.
Thank you so much for joining us for our Making It Magical presentation today, brought to you by Mansion Memories. Unfortunately, Mansion Memories wasn't able to have their magical days like they normally do due to COVID. So now we're going to bring them to you on video through our Making It Magical presentations on Sundays at 4 o'clock. Thank you so much to the Speakeasy in Redlands for housing us for this presentation. And it's beautiful in here. It's a wonderful venue. And also thank you very much to Ms. Diana Lawson with Mansion Memories for setting this up for us. And also a wonderful, glorious thanks to Ms. Mary Bodden with Dance Awareness. That's Dance Awareness, No Child Left Behind at danceawareness.com. Please go check out her website. It's something that every parent and dance teacher should be aware of. So we're gonna teach you all about ballet and pointe shoes today. So come on with us.
All right, guys, so we're actually going to be putting on the pointe shoes now, which is the part we've all been waiting for. But I would like to talk a little bit about the pointe shoes themselves first, because my biggest question when I was a young dancer was, what exactly do they put in there besides feet? So I do have something very special that I'm going to be showing you. But first, this is a pointe shoe. Yes, a pointe shoe. P-O-I-N-T-E, right? Not a toe shoe, that's a very old school terminology for these. So pointe shoes are constructed very specifically, all right? They have what's called a toe box, right? Which is this hard part here that we put our feet in. They have a platform, which is the part that you stand on when your foot is actually in the shoe, the box and the platform. This hard part of what we know in a normal shoe as a sole is actually called a shank, and it's very stiff and it helps us to pop up on the shoe. We also have a vamp, which if you can see if I bend it, it's this hard section of the shoe here that goes over the front of our foot to protect our toes and the front of our arches from overextension. We also have elastics here. This is an ankle elastic, and our ribbons. Yes, we also have a necktie. This is called the neck of the shoe. So we have a necktie here. Not like a necktie like your dad wears, but a shoe necktie. An ankle tie. Yes. Anyway, so this one goes around the shoe here. And every ballerina prepares and wears their shoes differently. We're gonna talk about that with Ms. Stromberg here. But firstly, I would like to show you what's actually inside the shoe. This was highly technical. Yes. Now, as you can see here, we have the elastic, half of the elastic, half the ribbon. This hard plastic part is our shank. Yes. And then this is our padding for our toe box. We have some extra padding here. And as you can see on the inside of the shoe, this was what's left of our vamp because we cut it in half. Yes. And our platform in the very front. I've always been very curious as to what's inside these, so I've very rarely seen one cut in half. So I think this is really, really cool. You can see the video. So. We had to put that big one here.
Guys, there it is.
Nice.
Half and half.
So another thing that I should mention is that pointe shoes inside are different. This is a certain brand. This is called a Gaynor Minden shoe. It's my favorite brand. It's what I wear. But not all ballerinas wear the same brand. What brand do you wear, Ms. Stromberg?
Mine is actually a block. And it, as you can see, it does not have the same curvature as hers. You'll hear dancers in certain communities, they consider those kind of like a cheater shoe. But at the same time, I prefer both. It just kind of depends on whatever the choreography is. I prefer these when I'm doing center floor. I prefer those when I am working specifically on bar, trying to execute leg extension and things like that. So it just kind of depends on your individual preference. And my shoe is actually constructed much differently than her shoe that she showed you. As you can see, my tie is up here at the top, and I have to tuck it in. Sometimes it can get uncomfortable because it kind of rubs on the top of the foot, but that's just how that cookie crumbles. I don't have elastics on mine because I buy my shoes. This is one of the other things the dancers do, is my shoes are actually too small for my feet. I like to feel like my foot is binded together. Because then it actually reduces chance of like either the shoe coming off or me feeling unstable while I'm dancing in the shoe. So I prefer it to just be a little snug when I'm wearing it. So I don't have elastics on mine because it's small enough to where when I shove my foot in it, it is going to stay. And then I tie my ribbons. So her ribbons are actually elastic, and she'll twist them around onto her foot. Mine are more of a traditional sense where you have to lace them around the ankle and tie them with a bow.
And we'll show you that right now.
So also in the tips of the shoes, I know it can be different as well. When you kind of stick your finger in and like push, there is a little bit of a toe padding, but not anything that you would want to immediately stand on. It's probably about big enough for maybe like your big toe and maybe the two toes next to it. So because of that, I know this is like a really big stigma. Even people who are not dancers know that dancers have the most ugliest feet in the world. And it's because of all of the strenuous activities that we put our feet through, like shoving them into a box to dance on.
And so
they make these extra little fluffies. As you can see, hers are much different than mine. Mine are more of a gel, it's a silicone, so that when I put them on my feet here,
and
it just covers just the toe.
And I use a combination. So this is kind of an older, this is a lamb's wool. And this is what the old school ballerinas used to use, this lamb's wool, and they would just kind of stuff it in there and pray, right? And I use a combination of some jellies. See, these are like a jelly that's on top of a sock. As you can see, hers are quite thick. I use a thin jelly with a really thick pad. So like Ms. Stromberg was saying, she likes her feet to be really binded in her shoe, so she gets a smaller size. I also like my feet to be deeply binded in my shoe, so I get a bigger size, and then I stuff it as much as I can. You'll hear some ballerinas say things like, I want to feel the floor.
I'm dancing barefoot.
Yeah, no, I don't want to feel the floor. That sounds terrible. So the process I do to put mine on is I take a little tiny bit of this little woolly, because if you notice, dancers and people have different shaped feet. So if you look here at my toes, we'll do this again. If you look here at my toes, you can see that my middle toe is a bit longer than my big toe here. Can you get a, yes. My big toe is a bit shorter than my middle toe. My middle toe is longer. So I have to take this little extra bit of padding to make up that space. Ms. Stromberg, what are your feet shaped like?
Mine are pretty decently curved across the edge, so I get a nice flat padding. That's one of the reasons why I like to just use this as well, because my first two toes are the same length, and then they just gradually grade down. That's why for my feet, I find it best for the gel, and then I always have to make sure that I am tied at the top, and that tie is shoved in. That way, when I go to shove my foot in, I have to wiggle it. It's kind of like putting on tights, if anybody's ever put on tights before. It's like you start at the very, very, very end, and then you slowly work up, pull them on, and my foot is in. that shoe. Then for mine, my laces just go around, and some, depending on where I tie them, probably just tie them here. And then because you don't want to actually see the bow, you tuck them under the laces so that all you see is the wrap. Perfect. And you always want to tuck your bow so that your Russian ballet teacher doesn't hit you with ties in the back. You should always tie your bow so it's not dangling out. Because when you're dancing and you do a beautiful turn and all of a sudden your beautiful ribbon goes, it's very distracting for the audience. Mm-hmm. Then your ballet teacher meets you. Can you tell the ballet people are strict? Yes? So, as you can see, I put my padding inside my tights. Put the tights over to hold the padding. You're not going nowhere, you little padding. And then, this is the part. This is the part that nobody likes. I should also mention, my shoes are brand new.
Yes, they are.
Now, when you have brand new shoes, because you saw what I did to my old shoes. When you have brand new shoes, nothing feels good.
Which is why I refuse to buy brand new shoes. Ever.
Unfortunately, that only lasts for so long.
It does. And if you're gonna buy new shoes, you wanna make sure that you buy them at least 6 months prior to when you actually have to wear them for real in a show or anything. Just because it does take a while to get that shoe to mold to your feet. Most people don't realize that shoes, normally when you buy a pair of shoes, it's very distinct on rights and lefts, which foot shoe goes on the right, which foot goes on the left. Dance shoes, you can just pick a foot.
You pick a foot and you put them on, but yep. Make sure after you do that, you remember what you picked.
Yes, because the shoe will eventually start to mold to that of the foot you have chosen to put it on. So you want to make sure that you repeat that same one. And it is kind of nice because even after the first wear, if you wore them long enough and did enough in them, the imprint of the big toe is still there. In pointe shoes, however, I could possibly have mine on the wrong feet.
Possibly. And the other thing too, just like anything else, when you're working with pointe shoes and you put your shoes on, sometimes you have a bad pointe shoe day and you just can't get your shoe on right. Everything feels crooked. Nothing fits properly. Your toes are mangled.
It's kind of how I'm feeling at the moment.
Your feet hurt.
Can't get my ribbon tucked in.
You know, sometimes you have some of those moments and you just gotta roll with it. So a note here, quick story time. When I first started dancing on pointe shoes, I did not get fitted properly. So any of you out there who are watching us and think, ooh, that looks like fun, I wanna try that. I definitely want you to try. But here's the thing, I would also encourage you to take classes. You have to take classes, you have to practice before you buy these shoes. My dance director calls them little pink coffins because it takes a lot of training. And if you don't have a sufficient amount of training, and if you don't practice this safely, you can really hurt yourself. Mm-hmm. I was one of those people. I was not trained properly, I didn't get fitted properly, and when it came around time for me to buy pointe shoes, unfortunately, I bought the wrong pair, and I broke several of my toes. Like a lot of them. Unfortunately, I didn't find out until later that I was wearing the wrong shoes because everybody has different feet, so everybody gets different shoes, which is why I wear this style and brand and Ms. Stromberg wears a different style because everybody has their own preference. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, also, when we're talking about pointe shoes, as you can see,
when we're in these things, our toes are straight up and down, right? Straight up and down. So when I'm up on top of these boxes here like this, my toes are literally pointing straight to the floor. And you'll see in the x-ray photo that I have for you. So the other thing that's interesting about pointe shoes is when you talk to like prima ballerinas, right? The ones who dance every day, they go through a lot of shoes, like a lot of shoes. We're talking a pair of shoes a week. We need new shoes. Now, why would you need new shoes? Because they get dirty? No, because they actually die. So there is such a thing called a dead pointe shoe. And what happens is this box here, it's really hard. Go ahead and tap on the floor there. Yeah, it's really hard. After a while, it gets soft and spongy and you can't dance on it anymore and it's dead. It's dead. It's bad for your ankles, and that's what they call a dead pointe shoe. So that being said, pointe shoes go dead quickly when you're a prima ballerina because ballerinas are very strong. Go ahead and go up on your elevators. Good. You have to be really, really strong to hold this position. So if you can imagine, all of this musculature in her foot squeezing the shoe is going to make the shoe weak at a certain point. Now, here's the problem though. Remember how we talked about my shoes are brand new? I can barely move them at all. Can you go to half point there, Sarah? Ooh. So half point here is when you have your foot bent. I can barely bend my foot because my shoes are brand new. Oh, that being said, a lot of ballerinas have processes that they do to break their shoe in quickly. Because if I got a brand new pair of shoes today, and I'm supposed to be on stage dancing the lead role tomorrow, I need to make sure that they work. So there's some ballerinas that will take their shoes, they spray them with water, they spray them with alcohol, they rough up the bottom, they'll beat the boxes, you'll catch them breaking them, cutting them, brand new shoes. Why would you do that to brand new shoes? So that they work properly. Now, this brand of shoes that I wear, the Gainer Minions, I prefer to break them in by dancing on them because they last much longer, which is actually why the woman who invented these invented them, because she was tired of buying her ballerinas brand new shoes every week because they're $70 a pair.
Yes.
Times 200 ballerinas. Mm-mm. So she said, no, we're gonna make shoes that last a little longer. So that's why these, if you notice, pictures.
Top or bottom?
Just make noise. No, top.
Riders are much louder than mine.
Hi guys. So this short video clip is just to demonstrate how I prep and sew my pointe shoes to get them ready to wear. This whole process takes about an hour because I have to put all the padding on my feet, put my feet in the shoes, and then decide where exactly I need my certain attachments. So this is my elastic that goes around the ankle. I already put one half, so I'm just showing you the other half. I place my elastics much towards the heel of my shoe because I have a high heel, and if the shoe heel is short, it will slip off my heel unless I have the elastic around the ankle. So I'm just securing it there, as you can see, right along the back. And then I have the ribbon. Now, I use elastic ribbon, and you definitely want to fold it over before you secure it so it doesn't fray. I use elastic ribbon that's quite different from regular ribbon, and I'll show you that in a minute, how different ballerinas tie their ribbons. This is just the way I like mine. See, and it's a loop. As you can see, the ribbon is stretchy too, which is kind of a new thing. We didn't always have stretchy ribbon. And so there it is, the elastics, the ribbon, and she's ready to go.
Thank you.
joining us on the program today. I would also like to invite you to please come check us out on Instagram. We are called Unity Dance Theater. Yes, please come check us out on Instagram. Come see our shows, come join us. You can email me at unitydancetheater@gmail.com. My name is Terrill Corletto, director, and that lovely model, one more time. Look at how gorgeous she is. This is my assistant director, Sarah Stromberg. So come check us out, can't wait to see you.
It was a pleasure partnering up with Mansion Memories and seeing What's the Point, and I hope you guys enjoyed every aspect of this presentation. And again, we thank you for being able to be here today. My name is Ariel, and I'm the owner of Speakeasy on State, and we hold weddings, events, small parties, corporate events. So again, thank you again for being able to be here, and I hope you guys enjoyed this presentation.